ಭಾರತದ ಹರಿದ್ವಾರದಿಂದ ಆಗಮಿಸಿರುವಂತಹ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಾದ್ಯಂತ 12 ಕೋಟಿ ಅನುಯಾಯಿಗಳನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರುವಂತಹ ಸುಮಾರು 75 ಲಕ್ಷ ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಸೇವಕರು ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಪಡೆಯನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟಿ ಇಡೀ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಾದ್ಯಂತ ಹೆಸರು ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥ ಪೂಜ್ಯರಾದಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಣವ್ ಪಾಂಡೆ ಅವರು, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಭಕ್ತಿಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದಂಥ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಬಯಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಣವ್ ಪಾಂಡ್ಯ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ವಿಶೇಷತೆ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ, ನೂರಾರು ಒಣಗಿರುವಂಥ ಬೆಟ್ಟಗಳನ್ನು ಹತ್ತು ಸಸರಿಸಿಗೆ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ವಿಶೇಷತೆ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಅವರ 12 ಕೋಟಿ ಭಕ್ತರು ಏನು ಬರ್ತ್ಡೇ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳೋದು ಒಂದೇ, ನೀವು ಬರ್ತ್ಡೇ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಗಿಡವನ್ನು ನೆಡಬೇಕು, ಆ ಗಿಡವನ್ನು ನೀವು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಗುಜರಾತ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಣಗಿದ ಬೆಟ್ಟಗಳನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಿಡಗಳ ನೆಟ್ಟು ಮೂಲಕ ಹಚ್ಚ ಹಸಿರು ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಣವ್ ಪಾಂಡೆ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ನಡುವೆ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಸಲ ಅವ್ರ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ 3000 ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗಳು ಏಕಕಾಲಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದೇ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಥ ಪ್ರಣವ್ ಪಾಂಡೆಜಿಯವರು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ನಮಗೆ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಖುಷಿ ಮತ್ತು ಸಂತೋಷ. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ಸದಾಕಾಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರಲಿ. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಗುರುಗಳು, ನೀವು ಸದಾಕಾಲ ನಮಗೆ ಗೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಈ ಮೂಲಕ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊತೇನೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ನಾನು, ನಮ್ಮ ಜಗದ್ಗುರು ಶಿವರಾತ್ರಿ ದೇಶಿಕೇಂದ್ರ ಮಹಾಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರು, ನನಗೆ 8 ವರ್ಷನಿದ್ದಾಗಿನೂ ನಾನು ಬುದ್ಧಿಜಿಯವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಸಿದ್ದೇಶ್ವರ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರ ಪರಮ ಶಿಷ್ಯರು. ಅವರ ಮೈಸೂರು ಬಂದಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಆವಾಗಿನಿಂದನೂ ಪೂಜ್ಯ ಜಗದ್ಗುರು ನಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಕೃಪೆ ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು, ನಾವು ಅಮೇರಿಕಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದಾಗಲೆಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಆಶ್ರಮ ಮೈಸೂರಿನ ಅಮೇರಿಕಾದ ಮೇರಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ಲಿ JSS ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಮಿಷನ್ ಇದೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ನಮ್ಮ ಯೋಗ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಗುರುಜಿಯವರು ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರು ಆರ್ಗನೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ.
ಪಾಂಡ್ಯಾಜಿ, ಟು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್.
Can all of you recite Gayatri Mantra with me? Om Bhur Bhuvah Swah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodaya. His Holiness Jagadguru ಹಿತ್ತೂರು ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿ, ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಶಿವರಾತ್ರೇಶ್ವರ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್, ಮೈ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಹೋಲಿನೆಸ್ ಶ್ರೀ ರವಿಶಂಕರ್ ಜಿ, ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ವಾಸ್ ಗುರು ಶ್ರೀ ವಚನಂದ ಜಿ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್, ಹೂಮ್ ಐ ನೋ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 22 ಇಯರ್ಸ್, the guests from the abroad who have come here, and the yogi who has come from here, his very tender touch to me is conveying all message to me that he loves me and he loves India. Language is no barrier. You see, he cannot speak Hindi, he cannot speak English, he cannot speak Kannada, but he can speak in the language in which he is trained by his Tibetan guru. So all the people who are present here, all the dignitaries who are present here from Mysore, from Bangalore, all the journalists who are here, and all the persons invited. Yoga has been established as a science, and this science is now being recognized all over the world. Our Prime Minister Narendra Modi established it as an International Day of Yoga from UN. And ultimately, we have been celebrating it since last 3 years. I celebrated with him in Delhi and in Chandigarh. And I know that he is very much interested that yoga should be the language of tomorrow, language of 21st century, of each and every being, and all the whole humanity will be united through yoga. We will all be united. Yoga means union. Yoga means union with the Almighty. microcosmos to macrocosmos. If we can unite microcosmos to macrocosmos, this is what is the yoga. Lord Krishna has very elaborately told in Gita about yoga. Samatvam yoga uchyate. Equilibrium is yoga. A proper balance in the life. Yoga brings in you the satisfaction in the minimum resources. Yoga brings in you what should be eaten, what should not be eaten. Yuktahara viharasya, yukti chastasya karmasu, yukta swapnao bodhasya, yoga bhavati dukha. All the pains and miseries which you have today, all the sufferings which you have today can be eliminated by yoga. Yoga is something which is purely scientific. I am MD in medicine and a cardiologist also. So I can tell you that I have been practicing it since childhood because my father was a very big yogi. He was a High Court judge, but still he used to practice everyday yoga. And he taught me to practice it. What I believe is that yoga not only makes the healthy mind, healthy body, healthy mind, but it brings a healthy society also. Swasth sharir, swachh man, sabhya samaj. Healthy body, clean mind, and civilized society. What is the need of time today? And this is the need of time because we are all enshrouded by the terrorist. We are all enshrouded, covered by, surrounded by people who believe in communal tension, people who believe in stress producing things. And there is so much of unpeace in the world. You can see it in the North Korea, you can see the confrontation occurring in the various countries. I think the future is very bright through yoga. The only solution is yoga. I consider myself as a scientist that the yoga is something which brings harmony in your body. Your whole system, your all structures are brought in unison through the yoga. We advise to the surgeons that you get the patient trained in yoga for at least 5 to 6 weeks before major surgery. Because after the yoga, there may not be any need of surgery. If the surgery is done, there will be recovery will be very fast. The anesthesia will not be given that deeper. And there will not be much lethargy in his body. There will not be much poisoning, much intoxication in the body. So this is purely scientific. Yoga, as Patanjali says in Yoga Sutra, Tatah kshite prakash avaranam. It gradually cleans the inner mind, our chitta. Very slowly, slowly it cleans and makes it sphatic mani, like a crystal. Our mind has to be clean today. Mind is very, very unclean, very dirty. Mind is doing all sorts of conspiracies and we have to clean that mind. You must have noted day before yesterday what happened in Las Vegas. A person with an unclean mind close to your building, in a high-storied building, he can kill anybody, anywhere in the world. Today it is happening. So for a secure society, we need everybody to be trained in yoga. I appreciate Swami Vachanandji Maharaj, Shwas Guru, for spreading the awareness about the pranayam, shwas shakti, power of breathing, and Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, whose art of living has brought people very closer to spirituality, all over the world, not only in India, but all over the world. Wherever I go, I find followers of Swami Sri Ravi Shankarji and Sri Vachanandji Maharaj. Jagadguru Shivratri Swamiji Maharaj, Chittur Swamiji has been very kind and very, 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 very dear to me. I had come earlier also to the Swamiji and I have stayed in his mutt. I believe that whatever he is doing for the educational world, this is the education which we need, the value-based education. and he is giving it. I am one of the person who is interested in changing the education policy of the country. The policy of the education system should be changed. It should not be based on the system which is based today. I run a university of which I am a chancellor, Dev Sanskriti University. After a week, I am inaugurating one more university, a branch of mine in Raipur. And we are going to have about more than 15 universities all over the world, gradually changing the setup of the whole educational network. I think a spiritual network, religious network has to come together with government. We have to clean the mindset of the children. And we have to bring yoga in education as deeper as possible. Moral education and the yoga. These are the two things which are very necessary. I was in Bangalore for opening a center for Gayatri Consciousness. We started it in Hosur Road, IT area, and it will be available for everybody. It has been opened on 1st of October. And I took about more than 150 IT professionals to Ooty for 2-day camp, and I talked to them one by one, one to one. I talked to them one to one as a by heart, and I learned many things which they are passing through. The stresses of today, the strain of today, the lifestyle disorders are to be cured only through yoga. Yoga is not merely postures. Yoga is not merely few things. Yoga is Ashtanga yoga. Yoga is much more deeper than that. And much more deeper than that, bringing meditation in practice. Meditation has to be there in the practice, and if this comes in regular life, then I think more and more quietened, more and more civilized, more and more energetic people we will have in society. I believe the yoga is going to be the religion of tomorrow. This yoga will unite all the religion, all Hindu, Muslims, Christians, Bodh, Tibetans, everybody will be united on yoga. All of us will be talking the one language, that is yoga, intercommunicating together, uniting together. This is something which is language of love, language of unity, language of unison, language of intercommunication, interdependence. I think this is what is going to happen in future. I believe in one concept, lastly, I'll just tell you, scientific spirituality. Science and spirituality need to be interrelated together. And I propagate it very, very commonly. I teach my students also. My university has about more than 5,000 students, very small university. But I foresee the centers coming up all over. And I presume that Swamiji, Jagadguru Shivaratrishar Swamiji, has more than 300 institutions. I want to inculcate the value-based education program which I have started in my university in Swamiji's institutions also, so that we can work together, we can work for the betterment of the society. The same offer I want to make to Swami Shri Shri Ravi Shankarji. Both of us together can work like anything for the betterment of the society, for the civilized society, for the stress-free society, and together, me from Haridwar, Ravi Shankarji from Bangalore, all of us, and Swamiji from Mysore, and a north and south combination, Krishna Kaveri and Ganga Yamuna union, this can do a lot of wonders. Thank you very much. All pranams to you, all to all of you.
ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರನ್ನು ಉದ್ದೇಶಿಸಿ ಉತ್ತಮವಾದ ಆಹಾರದಿಂದ ಸಾತ್ವಿಕ ಸಮಾಜವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಮಿಸಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಸದಾಶಯದ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಆಶೀರ್ವದಿಸಿದಂಥ ನಾಡಿನ ಬಹುದೊಡ್ಡ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಪರಿವಾರ ಹಾಗೂ ದೇವ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿ ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾಲಯಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಯನ್ನು ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಮುನ್ನಡೆಸುತ್ತಿರುವಂಥ ಪರಮಪೂಜ್ಯರಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಣವ ಪಾಂಡೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ಸಮರ್ಪಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇದು ಭಾರತೀಯ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿ ಪೂಜ್ಯ ಸುತ್ತೂರಿನ ಜಗದ್ಗುರು ಮಹಾಸನ್ನಿಧಿಯವರ ಪವಿತ್ರ ಪ್ರಾಂಗಣದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆದಂಥ ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಯೋಗ ಪರಂಪರೆಯ ಉತ್ಸವದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾರತಾಂಬೆಯ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಪುತ್ರರು ಯೋಗವನ್ನು ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಟ್ಟಿಸಿದಂಥ ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಯೋಗ ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಮಾನ ಸನ್ಮಾನವನ್ನು ಜಗದ್ಗುರು ಮಹಾಸನ್ನಿಧಿಯವರು ಇದೀಗ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ತಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಳಿತುಕೊಂಡು ಭಕ್ತಿಯ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳೆಯನ್ನು ತಟ್ಟುವ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಇರುವ ಉಭಯ ಯೋಗ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಇದೀಗ ಸುತ್ತೂರಿನ ಜಗದ್ಗುರು ಮಹಾಸನ್ನಿಧಿಯವರಿಂದ ಗೌರವ ಸಮರ್ಪಣೆ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಯೋಗಿಕ್ ಹೆರಿಟೇಜಿನ ಪೂಜ್ಯರಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಶ್ವಾಸಗುರು ವಚನಾನಂದಜಿಯವರು, ಗಂಗೇಶ್ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಅವರು, ಸಿ ಎಂ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಅವರು, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳ ಆಯೋಜಕರಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಎಸ್ ಎಂ ಶಿವಪ್ರಕಾಶ್ ಅವರು ಕೂಡ ಪೂಜ್ಯ ಗುರುಗಳವರಿಗೆ ಗೌರವವನ್ನು ಸಮರ್ಪಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಭಾರತಾಂಬೆಯ ಈ ಯೋಗ ಪರಂಪರೆಯ ಯೋಗ ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ತಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೃದಯ ತುಂಬಿದ ಭಕ್ತಿಯ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳೆಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗುರುಗಳನ್ನು ಗೌರವಿಸಬೇಕಾಗಿ ವಿನಂತಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ.